Your guess is as good as mine. We're just going to have a lot of fun here. It's the last show in the UK, and it's been great.
Yeah, and we're going to be counting down the top 10.
Oh, right. 10. I forgot about that. Top 10 videos of all time on Headbangers Ball that you guys voted for.
Yeah, we're going to see the top 10 videos as voted for by you, bringing you fun and games from the Skid Row European Tour on Headbangers Ball. Check this out. Yes, Headbangers Ball is back, and tonight it's a case of joining subhuman beings on tour because we're down at the Brixton Academy in London on the Skid Row European Tour. And joining me here on the show tonight, I've got Skid Row! Yay! Yeah! And the guys are going to be helping me count down the top 10 videos of all time. So stick with us for the next 90 minutes or so and find out who we're going to be counting down from 10 to 1. But before we go into the number 10 video, we're going to get the latest news on Skid Row. And I'll start with Sebastian. Welcome down to the guys, of course. How has the European tour been going?
Sold out, unbelievably. It's just great. We get to come back after, I think the last tour we did here was in 92, or was it 92? Or yeah. And, you know, we did Beside Ourselves, and we did Subhuman Race, and this is the first full-length tour that we've done, you know? It's the same tour as our first album, only more shows. So the more the merrier. Thank you, UK.
And, brilliant.
Yeah.
And you must have some kind of behind-the-scenes tour stories for us, some that you can tell us.
Well, yeah.
How have things been?
You guys want to talk?
Yeah.
Yeah, I get out so much. behind the scenes. Yeah, Rob, you.
What were you saying there, Rob?
I said.
Okay. Anyways,
that's really getting old. That trick.
I know, it always works.
Sold out gig tonight as well.
Yeah.
So there you go.
Yeah, and last night and the night before, and it's just a lot of fun. And we had to bump up the gig in Milan from a 4,000 seater to a 10,000, and this is the same place we played on the Slave tour. I love coming back and playing in the same places. Yeah. And Mike Dudney, the people at MCP, the promoters, said to us, "You guys want to do one night at NEC, one night at Wembley, and you know that'd be it." And we said, "Well, we can do that." He goes, "Yeah, we could do that." But we said, no, let's do it like we did on the first album.
Right.
You know, play lots of cities, not just three or four. So it's worked out really well.
Good. Well, you're going to be helping me count down the top 10 videos of all time as voted for by you, the viewers of Headbangers Ball. And at number 10, we got Danzig with Can't Speak. Anybody got any comments on Danzig or his video?
He used to be in the Misfits, just in case you didn't know.
True. You like this video, don't you?
I like this video. It's well done. I think Snake should write a song about... Oh, no. You gave up drinking, didn't you?
Right.
It's been, what, 20 days now?
23 days.
Oh!
I don't think he needs reminding, but anyway...
7 hours, 15 minutes, 42 seconds. Yeah. Thank you.
I was gonna say that Snake could write a song called Can't Speak After Having 4 Beers. Right?
Well, maybe that's what inspired the song, but actually we're going to just catch up with Danzig now, and he's going to tell us a little bit about his unusual songwriting technique when it came to the backwards song Can't Speak at number 10.
The backwards song Can't Speak.
Right.
That was just an experiment for me when I was trying to explain to Chuck, who's a drummer at the time, what to play to. He just looked at me and he didn't hear a beat in there, but I heard a beat in there, and I actually showed him the beat, and then he saw what I was thinking about.
So that was the number 10 video, Danzig with Can't Speak, and we're carrying on our countdown right now. We're backstage at Brixton Academy with Skid Row on the Subhuman Beings, Subhuman Race European Tour. And before we go into the number 9 video, as we're sort of counting down numbers and stuff, I just wondered, you guys, who's got a favorite film here? Has anybody got a number 1 film?
Repo Man would be mine.
Repo Man and Clockwork Orange. Yeah.
Probably Scarface. Mine. Scarface and Taxi Driver.
Taxi Driver.
Yeah, Taxi Driver. Oh, that's brilliant, isn't it? What about you, Seb?
Debbie Does Dallas.
But talking of films, Breaking Down has appeared on the Prophecy soundtrack. And I know that means a lot to you, Sebastian, because you're a big fan of Christopher Walken, who's in the movie, right?
Absolutely. Actually, the first time we were asked to do a movie soundtrack was, you remember Arnold Schwarzenegger, Terminator 2, and the You Could Be Mine thing?
Yeah, with Guns?
Yeah. Well, they asked us to do that before they asked Guns. Arnold went up to Atlantic and said, you got any new heavy rock songs? And he heard Monkey Business. And we're like, that'd be cool. But then they said that Arnold wanted to be in our video and stuff. So we're like, well, we don't know about that. So then I see the video come on. It's got all liquid effects and everything. I'm like, bah, you know.
Uh-oh.
But when this came around, they called us up. They really liked the song. And they wanted to use it for the movie. And Christopher Walken's always been like one of my favorite actors.
Yeah.
And we all watched the movie. And we liked it. And
brilliant.
So we said, let's go.
Yeah,
okay.
It's a cool movie.
Yeah.
It's very cool.
Good.
Coming out now.
Yeah.
Well, we're going to go into the number...
The video's sitting on the top of his TV probably at all.
He never gets to go home, that's the thing. Anyway, we're going into the number 9 video. We're going to go into the number 9 video right now, as voted for by you. Rachel, what we got coming up?
Nirvana Heart-Shaped Box. This is the video and song that made me actually start liking Nirvana. Because I never really listened to them because they got so popular. So... I dig it a lot. So, here it is.
Number 9. Hi there, welcome back to Headbangers Ball, counting down the top 10 videos of all time as voted for by you, the viewers of the ball, and we're doing it with Skid Row, and we've reached number 8 position, and coming up next we've got Sepultura. I've got some very hot news for you on Sepultura, but first I'm over to Sebastian because I think you're a big fan of the band. What's so great about Sepultura for you?
I love the drummer. I think he's... wicked player. I love their music. I love their songs. I like their lyrics. Ever since I got a CD player, though, I don't know the names of songs. The fourth one on this album is my favorite, but I love Territory, too. And I think this is a cool video in the mud and everything. I like how it goes slow motion when they're singing, but it still comes out at the same speed.
Yep.
I think that's really neat.
Yeah, filmed in Israel, of course, and they went into a lot of kind of off access areas in Israel, which is pretty fantastic as well. And actually the latest news on Sepultura is that they've just finished recording their new album Roots in Malibu in California. They've now moved over to New York to mix the new record, and it's fantastic because they've actually also been over to Brazil and they've recorded a Brazilian tribe out in the rainforest as percussion. That is true. Why are you laughing?
No, something he said. Nothing to do with that.
We were just wondering if Alex Haley produced it.
Well, I can tell you that
it
was produced by the same guy that did the Korn record. Do you like Korn?
Yeah,
yes.
I like Korn.
I like Cream Korn.
Really cool. That song's Blind. That is Korn.
Yeah.
Blind, yeah. That's really cool.
So
I like you guys. Like it matters to you or something.
We can't remember the producer's name, but anyway, Sepultura, their new album, it's going to be out in early 96, and we're going to be bringing you a lot of coverage of that new record, but right now we're going to turn the clock back to Chaos AD for the number 8 video, Sepultura, Territory. Check it out.
Hi, I'm Hi, how are you? So this next video is by Machine Head. and it's called Davidian, and I just want to thank the guys at Machine Head for getting me back from Castle Donington when these guys wanted to leave early. I did not. So I stayed there.
Rocks,
man. That's right. And so
well, we had a party with free booze to go to.
Free booze?
Yeah,
wow.
Remember?
Yeah,
I've never drank before. That's neat.
Donington Artichoke Bank.
Yeah, I know.
Well, that's why we didn't want you coming back with us.
They drove me there.
Now,
what,
you
so I liquidate the bar?
No.
Did you enjoy that party, by the way?
I can't remember. I think I did.
I did. The videotape proves that I did, that's for sure.
If you drink tequila, get drunk, and don't drive, or something like that. I don't give a shit, just get fucked up.
We all love Machine Head, right? Don't we?
We just love them. God, geez, they're so touching. When I hear Rob Flynn sing, it tugs at my heartstrings.
All right, it's the number 7 video as voted for by the viewers of Headbangers Ball, and this actually won.
Let freedom ring with a shotgun blast.
Brilliant. This one. The best video of the year last year at Headbangers Ball, and it's got into our chart at number 7. So we'll check it out. Machine Head currently looking for a new drummer to replace Chris Kontos, and they're going to be starting.
We're looking for a new one, too.
They're going to be starting a new album very soon, but for now we'll turn back the clock to their brilliant, brilliant video, Machine Head. Burn My Eyes. Davidian.
I mean, we were just amazed. I mean, they came out and like gave us the award for it, and all of us just sat there like, what are you talking about? You know, we were just like, it's such, it took us like, you know, it was like 10 seconds of silence before any of us even said, what are you talking about?
And then everybody started clapping, and that scared me, and then we all started clapping too.
Oh, okay, we won, oh, whoa. You know, we just, like, we didn't even think about nothing like that, you know.
Oh, it was a trip.
It was definitely an honor for us. I mean, that was just nothing that we expected.
So that was the number 7 video of all time as voted for by you, the viewers of Headbangers Ball. We just enjoyed Machine Head with Davidian. We are at the Brixton Academy with Skid Row, and right now we're going live on stage with Skid Row. Woo! Quick question.
All right! Come on, Brixton!
So, Sebastian, what's the funniest thing a fan has ever said or done for you?
Man, I can't believe you're trying to interview me while I'm in the middle of a kick jump that I practice in jiu-jitsu land.
Can you answer the question, though?
What was it again?
What's the funniest thing a fan has ever said or done for you?
Well, I think the funniest one would probably be the girl that came to the in-store back at Shades Record Store a couple years back and asked me to sign her meat. I go, what do you mean? She pulls out a Whopper, and I autographed it.
That's a good one. Okay, now we're moving over to Snake here. Snake, can you just interrupt guitar a second? What's it like trying to keep fit on tour? Because you don't look very well here.
I haven't for quite some time. That's why I quit drinking. I can't get my balance anymore. Sorry.
Okay. All righty, well, we're just going to go. Leave the guys on stage. Woo! And right now, we're going to go to the number 6 video. Hello? Here I am. And we're going to show you Paradise. Oh, sorry, you guessed it was
don't
a model.
Wreck it.
Okay, sorry.
They gave bucks for that stage. We paid big bucks for that stage.
Yeah, it's a very expensive
Stonehenge.
Production.
Stonehenge.
No expense spared on the Skid Row European tour. But anyway, we're going to go to the number 6 video. Woo! Paradise Lost, another award-winning video back from 1994 when you voted it the number 1 video of the year back then. Paradise Lost, Embers Fire. All right, hi, welcome back to Headbangers Ball. We're counting down the top 10 videos of all time with Skid Row, and Rachel's come outside with me right now. And there's something like 3,000...
Nobody even recognize me now, I got my hair.
3,600 people sold out gig tonight. There's some of them, pouring with rain. Wait, it's Rachel!
Collapse!
Rachel, what's your number 1 bass player?
Oh,
thank you. What's your number one bass player of all time?
Probably Gene Simmons, Paul McCartney, amen, and Dennis Dunaway from the old Alice Cooper band.
Really? Brilliant. Why did you, what inspired you to start playing bass guitar anyway, right back when you started?
The picture of Gene Simmons spitting blood and breathing fire inside Kiss Alive. I didn't even know what a bass was.
Brilliant. Yeah. Good. Well, we're going to find out some of the fans' favorite videos, so should we ask the fans?
Okay.
Oh, where's the Headbangers Ball viewer? He's a good-looking young boy.
How's it going, man?
How are you, man?
All right.
What's your favorite Skid Row song?
I heard about No Headbangers Ball this weekend. What's going on, man?
Well...
No Headbangers Ball. No. I've got MTV Text, you know what I mean?
Yep. MTV Text. No, it was taken off the air last week, but we're back.
They fucking rule, man.
We want to know your favorite Skid Row song.
Oh, man. That's it's a tough question. I love them all.
There's too many good ones.
There you go.
There's like too many good ones.
Right. Gone Wild, Breaking Down, anything you want. All the way from Peace of Me, Breaking Down to fucking anything, man.
What about you?
Oh, fuck, 18 and Life, man. 18 and Life.
Wasted time. Jesus.
Chris
and Jesus. Wasted time. Yeah, man. 18 and Life. Frozen.
All right.
Into another.
Into another puck of soul.
There you go.
This is a good band, and you go watch them, and you find out how good they are.
This
they
is a PR guy right here.
18 and Life.
We want 18 and Life.
18 Life.
Right, well, I'm pleased to say that there is a Skid Row video in the top 10 videos of all time. That's coming up very soon because we haven't reached it yet. But at number 5, it's Guns N' Roses. Very appropriate. November Rain. It's raining. November Rain, Guns N' Roses, number 5.
Corn.
This in our spare time. This is our spare time. Just we talk to you, Vanessa.
Well, I always love talking to you guys. Tell us a little bit about what is life like on tour with Skid Row. Is it total chaos?
Kind of orchestrated chaos, control chaos. This chaos. This right here. This is what it's like right here.
But you guys, you just love being out on the road, and you've done. How many shows have you done on this tour?
Good question. Probably close to about 150.
150?
So far, yeah.
Wow. Oh, there's a band coming on. We've reached the number 4 video for Skid Row, and it is Skid Row. And very quickly, this must have been such an exciting time for you when the Skid Row album came out, your debut album. It did brilliantly. Tell us a little bit about that time in your life.
It still seems like I watched the whole thing on TV. Because it's been so long ago, but it was great.
Number 4, Skid Row, 18 and Life. 18 and Life, you got it. 18 and Life, you know.
We tried to get Lemmy to sing it, but he wouldn't do it, so Sebastian decided he'd sing it instead. But,
so I'm with Snake now.
I think the Lemmy version
backstage.
Might be better.
Yeah, Lemmy, that was very good. You're very
Your grime is 9 minutes. 18 and Life to go.
And that was 18 and Life, number 4
that
in
was
the
cool.
It was.
Thank you.
Brilliant. Number 4, as voted by you, the viewers of Headbangers
Ball,
awesome. Top 10 videos of all time. From 1989, debut album, Skid Row, and I asked Rachel this, but I'd like to hear your thoughts. That must have been a very exciting time for you when that record came out and it went multi-platinum,
yeah,
I think
you
I'm
never,
right.
You never expect anything, you know, like when you put out a record, you're just pretty psyched that you got a chance to do it. And we had no idea what the response is going to be. And we started going out on tour, and I remember we started touring in January. January 25th, I think, was the first show of the tour. And we had never played arenas before, and this is an amazing thing for us. And all of a sudden, we're out playing, and all of a sudden, they start playing Youth Gone Wild on the radio and stuff. We're like, oh my God, I never thought I'd hear this song. And then 18 in Life, the video came out, and it just exploded. And it sort of took us completely by surprise, because you always hope for the best when you're doing it in front of a mirror, you know? But all of a sudden, you're seeing yourself on TV and stuff, and they're playing the hell out of it.
Rachel! So that was a brilliant time for Skid Row. And
the whole thing was, it was tremendous. And then I think that even as the years have gone on and stuff like that, it still remained equally as high, because the band has persevered through so many musical trends and whatnot. And it's still the same guys in the band after 9 years, and we're still respected or whatever, and
totally
viable, and it's great.
Brilliant. Well, congratulations for the
Thank
tour.
You.
It's been fantastic. We're going to
yeah.
show you some live performance later on.
Woo-hoo!
But as we are crunching numbers here at Headbangers Ball, who is your number one guitarist of all time?
I got this thing, it's between Eddie Van Halen and Randy Rhoads, and they both had such a huge impact on my life. That's why when Zach got the gig in Ozzy's band, I lived vicariously through him for a little while, because we're such good friends, and we got the opportunity to tour with Van Halen this year, which was beyond a dream come true. And the idea of just sitting in a hallway with your guitar and having him come up to you and stand next to you and just start jamming and talk to you, you're going, oh my God, Eddie Van Halen, you know? And I mean, the fact that they were so nice, and Eddie gave me and Scotty some of his amplifiers and stuff like that as a gift when we played in New Jersey, and I was like, man, never when I was, 15 years old in front of a mirror, jamming to You Really Got Me, or Ain't Talking, I Love That, I think that this guy would be giving me an amplifier one day, and we'd be on the same stage. So.
Well, that's a fantastic story, and it shows that your dreams can come true.
That's right, right here on MTV. Right.
Now, Skid Row is also a band that likes to give a little bit something back, and that's reflected in their support bands. You've got Send No Flowers out in the UK, and Apes, Pigs, and Spacemen in Europe. And, we're going to go and have a chat to Apes, Pigs, and Spacemen.
Well, the cool thing about being in this band is you get to choose, your opening bands, and you get to make a lot of friends. Unfortunately, that didn't happen with these guys. But anyway, at least you go talk to them.
Or should we go and see what's going on? Hello, MTV calling.
Everyone's getting quite pissed, you bastards.
So, Paul, how's the Skid Row tour going?
It's been very, very good so far, actually.
Nice. Snake's here. We really like them, and it's going so well, we can't believe. No, it's really good. These guys just need to learn to drink properly.
Especially me.
No, it's going really well. We're a new band to Europe, so we've been amazed by the response out there to our own set. But we're having a ball. It's just immense.
And the debut album, Transfusion, it's out now. And you've done two EPs. Why did you do two EPs first before the record?
Well, we thought if we brought an album out straight away, we'd have had the same reviews as we got for the first EP, sort of average response, nobody coming to the shows, so we wanted to do...
At least he's honest, you know, huh? You gotta love that, the guy.
Well, we've done 100 and odd shows this year. That was the idea. We've done 5 tours this year. Build up the fan base, get a loyal fan base behind us, let people know what we're really about, that it's a real band. So that's what this year's been about.
That was one of the things that appealed to us about them too, was that they had gone and done so much touring and released a bunch of music. So we were like, they seemed like a bunch of nice guys. Unfortunately, it turned out they weren't. So. But the thought was nice, you know?
So, Snake, you've seen them play a lot on the tour.
Actually, I was a fan of his when he was in this pop band I heard about.
Sandy Flip. All right. Snake, would you like to ask Paul something?
Who does your hair?
Who does my hair? It's Vidal Sassoon, actually. It's a guy called Serge, and I can put you in an appointment.
Actually, these guys can definitely tip a few pints, and unfortunately, I've been on a wagon as of late, so I've been kind of a sissy boy. But these guys, I'm living, again, vicariously through these guys, because they certainly put one on.
We're telling you what a good time we're having.
Absolutely.
All right, well, we're going to talk to Apes, Pigs, and Spacemen a lot more in the coming weeks on Headbangers Ball. Here's just a little preliminary chat with them. After our next short break, we've got the top 3 videos of all time to come, but right now we're going to show you a little bit of Apes, Pigs, and Spacemen here at Brixton Academy Live. Check them out on the Skid Row European Tour. Hi there, welcome back to Headbangers Ball. We're on the Skid Row tour in Brixton Academy in London. We're counting down the top 10 videos of all time, and coming up in just a moment, we're going to reach the number 3 position. And I'm still here with Snake, And I remember a quote from Charlie Watts from the Rolling Stones. He said he'd been in the business 25 years, he'd spent 20 years hanging around, and 5 years on stage. Now, there's a lot.
There's a lot of hanging around here. There's no doubt about it. It seems that's all we do every day, you know? And you're itching to get out there and just get all this energy out of your system, and you find yourself walking up and down the halls, going to catering, you know, just...
playing pranks on one another.
Exactly, if we can even do that. As you can hear in the background, there's some
warbling
going
on
there. I think it's Sebastian getting ready for the show and whatnot, but I don't know.
Yeah.
I can't do anything in the gym because he kicked my ass, but I think that you know.
Yeah. I can't come over here, but I
can't take care of it, yeah.
I just want to ask you one more thing before we go and see Seb. When you come off stage, though, there's a massive adrenaline rush, so it actually takes you quite a while to come down from that, doesn't it?
I just kick the hell out of Jim. Jim just stands around, he humors me, I kick the crap out of him for a little while, and he goes, okay, go away, little boy, and I know I'm done, and I go, away.
And this is the famous Big Jim. He's security for Skid Row. Big Jim, what's it like being out on the road with Skid Row?
Long. Real long.
Now, the thing is that Sebastian said that I could go in and chat to him while he's doing his
I don't think so, no.
Just push my button.
Private time.
Sebastian said I could.
No, I can't have done that. No way. No.
Fine, John.
Come in
here.
Wow,
so security you are.
Oh, there he is. Baz, we barged in. What are you doing? Warming up. He has to get the vocal cords in trim. How long is your warming up routine?
Remember
that second hook's
critical.
Metal, man.
You're close.
You're not going to get
rocked. Snake, why don't you come and do some of this? Come on, Snake. Let's see you do it.
How long's your routine to warm up? It's about 45 minutes.
It's longer than the opening band's on. They're on the whole time. I start before them and finish after.
Right.
Felice.
Well, thank you for letting us in here.
Felice.
And we got a new video coming up.
Andy Felice.
Number 3.
Andy Felice.
Pearl Jam.
Andy Felice.
Jeremy.
You mean they need to cancel their video?
No, Pearl Jam, Jeremy, number 3!
Andy Felice.
It is very relevant in America today.
Okay, welcome back to the final part of the Headbangers Ball. It's the top 10 videos of all time countdown. Doing it in fine style with Skid Row. We're going down to the number one and down to the wire because Skid Row are on stage in literally 5 minutes. So Baz, as you can see, is getting ready. And just
Make myself look like I haven't been on the road for a year.
Well, you look fantastic.
Oh, well, thank you very much. I'm giving myself eyebrows. When God handed them out, I must have been away or something.
Now, you're the person to ask this very quick question.
Yes.
We're going into the number two video from Soundgarden, and they're a band that don't like to be called metal, and I think Skid Row and also Rob Halford, the true metal god, are some of the only people that actually are happy to be called metal.
Well, I'm just happy to be called something. You can call me anything you want, as long as you're talking about me. Soundgarden didn't have a problem when they were opening up for us for 2 months in the States. Our crowd and their crowd were like the same people. I mean, the people that had Slave to the Grind had Bad Motorfinger right next to it, you know. That's why we're still doing this, you know, and a lot of bands aren't. It's because our music, just it's got a lot of energy to it, which I can't seem to quite control right now.
How do you get, like, psyched up for the gig? Tell us what you do.
I my warm-up, and those people do all the psyching for me.
Yeah, and you're using ear monitors now, right?
Yes. Actually, I'm using them right now.
And does that make a difference for you on stage?
It's the difference between, screaming and singing, basically. I can hear everything in these things. Before, it was kind of like sticking your head in the engine of the Concorde and trying to sing Amazing Grace. You know what I mean?
Fantastic.
Ricky was a young boy. And Rachel's like, I'm like, man, could you turn that down? It's on 4. I didn't say what number is it. Okay, time to go.
All right, number 2 video is Soundgarden, Black Hole Sun from Super Unknown. Okay, that was Soundgarden at number 2 with Black Hole Sun. And before we find out the number 1 video, we're going to check out the chart. And at number 10, we had Danzig with Can't Speak.
everything they want.
At number 9, Nirvana, Heart Shaped Box. Hey,
wait, I gotta move away. Yeah, and number 8, video is Sepultura with Territory. Yeah! One more
territory. Yo. Hey, at number 7, the award-winning video from Machine Head, Davidian. See ya.
With the shotgun blast.
And this is the number 6 video of all time. It is Paradise Lost with
Ember's Fire.
Ember's Fire, yeah.
Don't run away from the pain.
And at number 5, it's Guns N' Roses with November Rain.
And it's hard to hold a candle in the cold November rain.
Hi there. At number 4, Skid Row, 18 and Live.
18 and Life, you got it. 18 and Life, you know.
And the number 3 video is Pearl Jam with the story of Jeremy.
Yeah.
Yes!
Number 2 is my favourite band in the world, Soundgarden, with Black Hole Sun.
Black Hole Sun, won't you come, won't you come?
Okay, that was Soundgarden with the number 2 video. That was Black Hole Sun, and we've reached the number 1 video of all time. It's voted for by you, the viewers of Headbangers Ball, and it is appropriately Metallica.
Quick as does the day.